So who's gonna be holding up the bigger stimulus checks? Well, obviously Mitch McConnell is a big name there, but he's not the only one who could potentially throw a wrench in this. We've also got Rand Paul. Rand Paul very worried about just giving money to people, as he'll make clear in this clip.
I think there are a lot of things. I think giving money though to people who are already working. Look, my kids are working and don't need a check. They're not rich, but they don't need a check. And most working Americans don't need a check right now. It's a really foolish, egg-headed, left-wing socialist idea to pass out free money to people.
Okay, so Rand Paul's got a big issue with the fact that these people who are suffering, and he thinks like if you have a job, you're perfectly fine and you've got no troubles during this massive economic downturn. And why wouldn't he know that? I mean, he after all is only, you know, a multimillionaire senator who doesn't have to really work and has no idea what's actually going on. So it's easy for him to think that helping people who are dying is egg-headed. What a weird, disconnected way to portray that. But also bear in mind that this is a guy who has an issue with just giving money to people, who also voted for the Trump tax cut that gave literally trillions of dollars to the wealthiest people in the history of our world. So maybe it's more to do with the people that are getting the money than the money being given to people in the first place.
Last I heard, Wall Street bankers, defense contractors, large corporations, the people who work for, they have these things called jobs. We give billions to them. So we're talking about giving money away to people who have jobs already. We do that on a regular basis all the time. In fact, we say it stimulates our economy if we give them more money so that they can trickle it down to people who don't get those jobs and they get hoarded and put and slashed in their own bank accounts. Yeah, that's what actually happens with the money. But you know, when those things happen, Rand Paul may stand up and go, we're spending too much, and sit back down and vote for it. So this holy crusade that he's on to say we're wasting money on irregular American people, again, he's putting his face and his name out there. Go ahead, let's shine the spotlight on him. Rand Paul does not care about what you're going through. He, in fact, is happy about what you're going through, and he says that you don't need any more money. Hey, this is Christmas time. People sometimes rely on tax returns coming in February, March, April to pay back the debt that they have during Christmas when they bought all these gifts that they couldn't afford. That happens on a regular basis. So people are in that crunch right now, and it's even worse because many of them haven't had jobs for months. Start saying to them now, it's Christmas time. Where are the Grinches? Who are the people that don't want you to put gifts under the tree for your children? Hey, your kid asked for that new toy. You can't afford it, or if you buy it, you don't know when you're gonna be able to pay it back. You know who's against that? Rand Paul's against you having a Merry Christmas. Go ahead, just make it materialistic. They do it every time. They talk about freaking Starbucks putting Happy Holidays on cups. They made a crusade out of it. But we can't make a crusade out of people not being able to afford to stay under to live under a roof. This is crazy, man. It's way too easy. They're setting us up, and we're not hitting home runs.
Rand Paul is waging a war on Christmas. My book will be coming out in just a couple of weeks. That's basically what's going on. That's what's going on. And exactly, yeah, I know. He had issues with the Trump tax cuts, but I guess in the end, I'll give myself a tax cut. Seriously, when people support themselves getting money, I don't care at all about the conversation around the edges for it. It's their own economic interests. He's totally fine with trickle down economics. Why don't we get some like trickle up economics? Because here's the thing, at the end of the day, we're still a capitalist society. So when you give the money to people who actually need it, they will then spend it. It's gonna end up in the pockets of the rich someday. Why shouldn't we at least temporarily benefit before that happens? Let's add a middleman. And the middleman and the middlewoman is suffering in America these days. Let's let them get a little bit out of the money before it ends up going to Jeff Bezos and Elon Musk and whatever at the end of the day. It's definitely gonna happen. Yeah. People are suffering. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.